We're gonna work a little bit more on this watercolor painting. I'm gonna try to give you some tips on how to do watercolors. When you mix your paints, it's always best to start with your lightest colors first and get them all out on your palette. And then rinse out your brush, dab it off, and then go to your darker color. That way you're not mixing your colors in your palette. That might be just a pet peeve of mine, but I gotta keep my colors pure in my palette. I mix them on my palette, but I do not mix them in my palette. And today I'm going to be using burnt sienna, and I'm gonna be mixing it with ultramarine blue, because we're still working on this beautiful horse I paint on paper. And I sure hope this camera setup gives you a better view than my last camera setup did. That was my iPad. This is my Canon. And I sure hope it works better. So I need to start adding some more detail in here. And just like before, follow the direction of the hair. And as you start rounding around the body, the hair also round. Boy, this is gonna be hard. The hair also rounds around the body. So on their back, the hair is straight. But right at the backbone, the hair branches off on both sides. So I'm gonna start bringing down some of this hair. Just little short flicky strokes. And then I'm just taking a little bit of water and I'm softening out what I just put down. And that's just all I do over and over and over again. I'm gonna pull down these lights a little bit. I want this one. All right, so right here. And we're gonna mix a really light mix of bluish gray. We're just gonna drop this in. This is right at the joint here. I take and I soften up the edges. Oops, and I got too much water. So then you just take your damp brush, you wipe it off on your towel, and you bring it back in and dab, which removes some of the water where you got too much water. Oh boy, that is really dark. So we will definitely soften that out for sure. And of course, as you know, well, maybe you don't know, but watercolor, as it dries, it becomes lighter in color. So what looks like really dark is actually going to be very light once it dries. And it is so warm here today that these paints are not staying wet for very long. So I might have to actually stop and wait for this to dry completely before I can continue on. So far, we're all right. It's still allowing me to kind of mark in my edges here.
Softly and gently.
And I've got a bad angle here. Probably because I'm standing up instead of sitting down.
So that I'm out of the way of the camera. There, that looks better. What do you think?
Better. I'm pretty pleased with how that looks. Alright, so then we got something around here. As you can see, I just boo-booed and brought this line too long, so I'll just dab it off with water and away it goes. Soften out this one because I want this to be a gradual. I don't want it to be a really in-your-face type of transition. And of course, we got right down the middle. Also got that little brown spot, which is right about there. Thank you. just winging it. There's no no lines on this. I did not bother to draw in this kind of stuff on my original sketch, because that's just the way I work. I'm still just doodling along here. This needs to be so much darker. As I said, I'm pushing myself to really get my darks. Most expensive style paper here. Deal. As long as I don't put my head in the way.